we are going to discuss the problems related to force. So I hope everyone has the textbook of physics. In this, open the first chapter, force. First chapter, we have examples problems. In that example problems, we are going to solve the first problem. A body is pivoted at a point, a force of 10 Newton is applied at a distance of 30 centimeter from the pivot. So, calculate the moment of force about the pivot. So, here what they have given? They have given one body and it is pivoted at a point. A force of 10 Newton is applied at a moment at a distance of 30 centimeter. So we know the formula. Moment of force equals force into perpendicular distance. So we know the formula. Moment of force equals force applied into perpendicular distance. So what they have given here in the first example problems? In the first example problems, they have given a body is pivoted at a point A and a force of 10 Newton is applied. So what they have given? Force of 10 Newton is applied to a distance of 30 centimeter. So what is the distance here? 30 centimeter. So what they are asking now? They are asking to find the moment of force applied. So what is the formula we should use here? Moment of force equals force applied into perpendicular distance. So this is the formula we should use here. And next, what we should find? Force applied equals 10 Newton and that should be multiplied by the distance that is given in 30 centimeter. We should convert it into meter. That will become 30 divided by 100. So what we will get? 0.3 meter. So we should convert this distance from centimeter to meter. So what will be the answer here? 10 into 0.3. The answer will be 3 Newton meter. So this is the answer. When a force is applied, Newton of force is applied to a distance of 30 centimeter, the moment of force equals 30 Newton meter. Shall we solve the next problem here? Example 2, the question is, the moment of force of 5 Newton about a point P is 2 Newton meter. Calculate the distance of point of application of force from the point P. Here in this problem, they have given the moment of force and the force applied and they are asking to find the distance, perpendicular distance. So what they have given? Moment of force, that is 5 Newton, and the force applied. And the force applied equals, this is 2 Newton meter and this is force applied is 5 Newton. And they are asking to find the perpendicular distance. So we know the find the perfect distance. So cross multiply, we should find the D. So it will become 2/5. That is equals 0.4 meters. Perpendicular distance. न्यूटन मीटर इक्वल्स व्हाट इज द फोर्स अप्लाइड 50 न्यूटन एंड वी डोंट नो द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस सो व्हाट वी शुड फाइंड हियर वी शुड फाइंड द डिस्टेंस द डिस्टेंस इज नथिंग बट द लेंथ ऑफ द हैंडल सो 60 डिवाइडेड बाय 50 0 0 cancel that is newton meter newton newton meter also get cancel what you are left over with only meter what you have answer here 6 divided by 5 so the answer will be if you have doubt you can divide it 6 divided by 5 5 ones are 5 1 keep a point, add a 0, 5 2's are 10, so what will be the answer here, 1.2 meter is the length of the lever to up, by using this lever we can open the net with a force 50 newton. The fourth example problem in your textbook that I will read the question here. The iron door of a building is 3 meter broad. It can be opened by applying a force of 100 newton. So, the iron door of a building is what? The iron door of a building is what? 3 meter and these are the given terms. First write given here. By using a force of 100 newtons. So I consider this as a iron door. In order to open this iron door of building, this iron door is a 3 meter. Length of the iron rod is door is 3 meter. So what is the force required to open it? That is 100 newton. Normally at the middle of the door. So that applying a force in the middle portion of the door in a open it. So what they are asking is calculate the torque needed to open the door. So what is torque here? Torque is nothing but the turning effect of force. So what is the formula to find the torque? The same formula, force applied into perpendicular distance. Here they are given one iron door of breadth 3 meter and they are applying the force in the middle of the door using force of 100 newton. So now they are asking to find the torque of the door. So what is the formula? Torque is nothing but moment of force. Force applied into perpendicular distance. So one thing you should observe here, the breadth is 3 meter, the breadth of the door is 3 meter and they are applying force not at the end but they are at the middle of the door. So what we should find? So this will be the diameter. So we should find only half of the breadth. Why? Because they are applying force in the middle portion. So this is divided by 2. So what you will get? That is nothing but half. 3 divided by 2. 1.5. Okay. So 1.5 meter is the distance. So torque equals, what is the force required here? 100 newton. And what is the distance? 1.5 meter. So multiply this, you get an answer. 5 into 0, 0, 5 into 0, 0, 5 ones are 5. Add one decimal after one digit. Next to 5, 1 into 0, 0, 1 into 0, 0, 150 न्यूटन मीटर. दिस इज द एब्सॉल्यूट ओनली द एट सम. इन द फोर्थ क्वेश्चन, सो व्हाट इज द बी प्रॉब्लम, द लीस्ट फोर्स एंड इट्स पॉइंट ऑफ एप्लीकेशन टू ओपन द डोर. सो व्हेन वी शुड अप्लाई ओनली द लीस्ट अमाउंट ऑफ फोर्स इन ऑर्डर टू ओपन द डोर. सो हियर वी शुड अप्लाई द मैक्सिमम फोर्स इन ऑर्डर टू ओपन. इफ आई कंसीडर दिस एज अ डोर ऑफ लेंथ 3 meter, in the previous sum, that is the A sum, we have applied the force in the middle portion of the door. But here we should use only less amount of force in order to open the door. So when we should apply the force, if the perpendicular, if the distance is more from the handle, this is the hinge. This portion is the hinge. So if this is the handle, so where we should apply least amount of force, if the distance is more from the handle, it requires only least amount of force. So here we should consider D equals 3 meter. So at the other end of the door, we should apply the force which requires only less amount. So D is 3 meter. Next force equals what? 100 Newton. Figure drawn on the board, a roller of diameter 0.4 meter. A roller of diameter, this is a 0.4 meter, is raised on the pavement By using the forces F1 and F2, each of magnitude 10 Newton. So what will the force, magnitude of the force? F1 and F2 equals 10 Newton. So compare the torques. Compare the torques produced by two forces. So here they'll use two forces, F1 and F2. And the magnitude of two forces is 10 Newton. And what will be the diameter? It is 0.4 meter. They are asking to find the torque of these two forces. See here, in F1, when a force, F1 force is applied, it will, the perpendicular distance will be 0.4 meter. When a F2 force is applied, because F2 force is applied at the middle portion of the, this rod. So what will the F2 diameter? It will be R by 2, that is 0.2 meter. So what is the formula to find the torque of F1? That is F1 into perpendicular distance. Torque, to find the formula for F2. F2 into perpendicular distance. So what we should do here now? We should compare these two forces, compare the two torques produced by two forces. That is F1 into D1 divided by F2 into D2. So what is F1? We already know that is 10 Newton into, what will be the D here? In front of F1 force, the D will be 0.4 meter. So what is F2? F2 is also 10 Newton into, what will be the D2? D2 will be 0.4 divided by 2, because the force is applied from the middle portion of this circular rod, that is 0.2 meter. So when we cancel this, what we will get? 10 Newton, 10 Newton will be cancelled. So we are left over with only 0.4 meter divided by 0.2 meter. 0.2 meter once are 0.2. So what will be the, when you compare these two torques, what will be the difference? The difference will be 2 by 1. So this exercise 1.A, which is given in your textbook, exercise 1.A. Here we should next go for the numericals. These are example problem. Next we should solve the numericals of the exercise. In exercise 1A, we should solve the numericals. That the first problem, second and third problem will be the similar as we solved in the example problems. Now move on to fourth problem. Diagram for the exercise problem, fourth problem we are solving now. That is, I read a question written on the board, shows two forces, that is F1 equals 5 newton and the F2 equals 3 newton. So what was right in given terms? F1 equals 5 newton, F2 equals F3 newton. Next, what they are asking is, acting at the points A and B of a rod pivoted at a point O. So these two forces acting on a rod which is pivoted at a point O. So these two rods have ends A and B respectively. That is nothing but OA from the that is pivoted distance, that is OB. So what is OA? 2 meter and OB equals 4 meter. This problem is based on the verification of the principle of moment of force at equilibrium. Next, what they are asking? They are asking three, here in this problem we have three sub questions. First sub question is, calculate the moment of force F1 about O. So what we should do here? Should calculate the moment of force at F1. The first sub question is, so what is the moment of force formula? F1 into perpendicular distance. First sub question they are asking to find the moment of force F1 about O. We already know what is F1, 5 newton, and what is the perpendicular distance, that is OA. Because from over they are asking OA equals what? 2 meter. So what is the moment of force at F1? 10 newton meter. So the moment of force at F1 equals 10 newton meter. So next asking the moment of force F2 about O, from O. And the second moment of force will be of magnitude 10 Newton act vertically upwards. That is, they act on opposite directions of upwards and downwards respectively at two ends A and B of a uniform rod of length 4 meter, which is pivoted at its midpoint O, as shown in the figure. Next, what they are asking is to find the determine the magnitude of the resultant moment of forces about a point O. They are asking to find the resultant moment of force acting about a point O. So what they are given here? They are given two forces, F1 and F2. That is nothing but 10 Newton. So and their distance is 4 meter. Next, what they are asking? They are asking to find the moment total, the magnitude of the resultant moment of forces. So first, what we should find? First, we should find the moment of force F1 about the point OA. First, we should find the moment of force at OA at F1, that is F into F1 into perpendicular distance, that is nothing but OA. So for that we should find the OA distance, that is nothing but D divided by 2. What we will get? 2 meter.
Negative sign. So what will the total moment of forces?
half of the distance, that is nothing but OA. So that is a length divided by 2, that will get 2 meter. Moment of force at F1 equals F1 into perpendicular distance, that is nothing but 10 newton into 2 meter, that will get be getting 20 newton meter. It works in the anti-clockwise direction. Next, moment of force F2. F2 equals F2 into perpendicular distance. F2 equals 10 newton into 22 meter, that will be getting 20 newton meter. This will be the clockwise direction, F2 force. Next, they are asking to find the total moment of force about a point O. That is, total moment of force equal 20 newton meter plus 20 newton meter. So what is the answer? 40 newton meter. Thank you, children. We'll be continuing the next class.